Hi all, welcome to Data Structure using C class. In this video, we are going to discuss asymptotic analysis of algorithms. In the last class, we had a discussion about performance analysis, time complexity, then space complexity, operation count, step count in time complexity, all that. Today we are going to discuss asymptotic analysis. So, asymptotic analysis refers the computing the running time of any operation in mathematical units of computation. It refers to computing the running time of any operation in mathematical units of computation. For example, the running time of an operation is computed as f of n, and maybe for another operation it is computed as g of n square. The running time of one operation is computed as f of n, and maybe for another operation it is computed as g of n square. So these are the functions f of n and g of n. F of n and g of n. So this means that first operation, this one, running time will increase linearly with the increase of n, and the running time of the second operation will increase exponentially when n increases. So similarly, the running time of both operations will be nearly the same if n significantly small. This is the chart. We know that asymptotic analysis of an algorithm refers to defining the mathematical framing of its runtime performance. So using asymptotic analysis, we can very well include the best case, average case, and worst case scenario of an algorithm. Best case, average case, and worst case scenario of an algorithm you can conclude using asymptotic analysis. So these are the simple pictorial representation of best case, average case, and worst case. We will get the best result in best case, average result in average case, and worst result in worst case. So going to this topic, best case, average case, and worst case. First one, worst case. Worst case, this is the scenario where a particular data structure operation takes maximum time it can take. Maximum time it can take. If an operation worst case time is f of n, then this operation will not take more than f of n time, where f of n represents function of n. This is worst case. In this, a particular data structure operation takes maximum time it can take. So moving to next case, that is average case. This is the scenario depicting the average execution time of an operation of data structure. If an operation takes f of n time in execution, then m operation will take m f of n time. This is average case. Now moving to best case, this is the scenario depicting the least possible execution time of an operation of a data structure. If an operation takes f of n time in execution, then the actual operation may take time as the random number which would be maximum as f of n. So these are the three cases related to time in asymptotic analysis. You need to remember these cases, worst case, average cases, and best case, to illustrate asymptotic notation. So this is the pictorial representation. Best case you will get the result in a fraction of second. Average case takes more time than best case. Then worst case means it takes more time or more memory to execute a program. So these are the cases: best case, average case, and worst case. Keep in mind. Now we are moving to asymptotic notations. We know that Asymptotic analysis of an algorithm refers to defining the mathematical foundation or framing of its runtime performance. Using asymptotic analysis, we can very well conclude the best case, average case, and worst case scenario of that algorithm. Now, the following are commonly used asymptotic notation to calculate the running time complexity of an algorithm. First one, big O notation. Second, omega notation, and third, theta notation. Big O notation, omega notation, and theta notation. These are the commonly used asymptotic notations to calculate the running time complexity of an algorithm. So, commonly used asymptotic notations are big O notation, omega notation, and theta notation. Keep in mind the symbol big O, omega, theta notations. Moving to big O notation, the notation big O of n is the formal way to express the upper bound of an algorithm's running time. It is the formal way to express the upper bound of that algorithm's running time. It measures the worst case time complexity or the longest amount of time an algorithm can possibly take to complete. It measures the worst case time complexity or the longest amount of time an algorithm can possibly take to complete. So this is big O notation. It is the formal way to express the upper bound of an algorithm. It is the formal way to express upper bound of an algorithm. So here we have the cases. So this is big O notation. It is the formal way to express the upper bound of an algorithm's running time. It measures the worst case time complexity. Now, moving to next notation, that is omega notation. The notation omega of n is the formal way to express the lower bound of algorithm's running time. It is the lower bound of an algorithm's running time. So, it measures the best case time complexity for an algorithm. So, it measures the best case time complexity of the or the best amount of time an algorithm can possibly take to complete. So this is the expression. So this is omega notation. It is the formal way to express the lower bound of an algorithm's running time. Now moving to last one, theta notation. Theta notation means it is the formal way to express the both the lower bound and upper bound of an algorithm's runtime. It is the formal way to express both the lower bound and the upper bound of an algorithm's running time. It is represented as follows. Here we have upper bound, then here we have lower bound. It represents both the lower bound and upper bound, and you have the expression here. So this is the simple illustration to understand time complexity and asymptotic notation, worst case, best case, and average case. Big O notation, formal way to express the upper bound of an algorithm's running time. Then omega notation, it is the formal way to express the lower bound of an algorithm's running time. And theta notation, it is the formal way to express the both the lower bound and upper bound of the algorithms running time. So some common asymptotic notations are here. For constant you can use big O of n, for logarithmic of log n, then linear equations of n, then n log n O of n log n, then quadratic equation O of n2, then cubic O of n3, polynomial n of 1, then exponential 2 O of n. So these are the common asymptotic notations. I hope you understand asymptotic notations. So thank you.